associated regulations. For those of you who don't know, a Section 21 notice is a notice given by a landlord to a tenant requiring possession under Section 21 of the Housing Act 1988. It's sometimes referred to as the no-fault eviction procedure, and it's one of the first steps that a landlord does need to take before actually seeking possession of the property. So despite the legislation actually coming into force just over 2 years ago, it's still surprising just how many residential landlords I do come across who don't know about the changes and their obligations under the legislation, and it can leave them in a very difficult position really when it actually comes to seeking possession of the property. First point to note is that the legislation only applies to short-term rental tenancies that have come into force on or after the 1st of October 2015. As of the 1st of October 2018, it will apply to all tenancies regardless of when they were created. So it's definitely something to look out for and start preparing for. So what are the changes then? Well, in some respects, it's the notice requirements have been quite simplified for landlords in that there's now a prescribed form. And also the notice no longer has to expire on at the last day of the period of tenancy. So I think there's less scope for what tenants will argue. The courts are less likely to find that the notice is invalid on those grounds. The legislation does, however, place more obligations on landlords in that before a Section 21 notice can be served, the landlord has to serve a valid energy performance certificate and guest safety certificates and a document on how to rent in England before they can even start serving a Section 21 notice. There's also a number of new time periods that have been introduced as well, in that a Section 21 notice cannot now be given within the first 4 months of tenancy. And it also has a longer stop date of 6 months. So if you've not issued court proceedings within 6 months of actually serving your notice, then you're going to have to serve another notice of a minimum of 2 months notice period. So the overall effect then of the new legislation is just to impose more obligations upon the landlord before they can even start thinking about seeking possession of their property. This is just a very, very basic, very general guide to obtaining possession of a Section 21 notice. So if you've got any specific case-specific questions, then obviously come over and ask. We're bringing things more up to date. I know that the government are now looking to introduce a ban on letting agents' fees. There was a consultation earlier this year, but we still haven't got an implementation date, have we? So again, that's something to look out for and to start being prepared for. Well, that's it from me. Thank you very much for listening to me.